Since the Heroes of Skyrim expansion was announced at E3, we've had a couple of cards revealed from the new set, but on the showroom floor, there were some people who were able to play with some of the new cards. They were doing demos and letting people try out one of two different decks. As a result, some images have been making their way to the public, some via publications like PC Gamer, others are just screenshots that people were able to snag and share. So we've got some more cards to kind of look at and talk about from the new set, and that's exciting. Without, I guess, much more, let's just go ahead and dive into it. There's been six cards that are at least confirmed because we've got screenshots of them, and let's see what we got. So the first card that we're going to look at was an official reveal. It was revealed on CVH's live stream, and it was our first look at Shouts at the time. The card is Unrelenting Force, and it reads, 3 Magicka, unsummon a creature that is power 3 or less. It's a strength card, it's an action. The obvious comparison that everybody is going to make right out of the gate, and rightfully so, is this card against Cast Out. Cast Out unsummons any creature regardless of power and has prophecy. So, comparatively, it feels very underwhelming. However, Shouts have 3 levels. So the first time you play a Shout, you get the level 1 effect. The second time is the level 2, and the third time is level 3. So level 2 of Unrelenting Force is matching the power level of Cast Out, but without the prophecy. So you just straight unsummon a creature. Level 3, however, is bananas. 3 Magicka, unsummon all enemy creatures in a lane. Do not pass go. Do not collect $200. You just bounce them. And that is very, very strong, as you might imagine. Now, it could be very difficult to set up because you have to get all 3 copies and play them, but we know, or at least we've been told, that there may be other mechanics for leveling up your Shouts, and as we are going to see a little bit later, there are some mechanics that will help you acquire Shouts, either from your deck or at random, and now that we have seen that they are for sure actions, even cards that were previously teased, like College of Winterhold, may have the option to also create copies of Shouts. So it's underwhelming until you get to the like level 3 version, but whether or not that is as bad as it sounds, I mean, there's no way to know. Very, very, very few cards of the set have been revealed. We have no way to know how synergistic the things are going to be, and all we can really compare it against is the current cards and the current meta. So like, again, right now it feels underwhelming, but that does not mean that it's not viable by any means. As it is, this is just the first Shout, so why not just go ahead and look at the second Shout that was revealed? So I'm going to apologize for the potato image up front, but this is coming from a screenshot that somebody took at E3, and when I say screenshot, I mean like actually a picture of a screen that somebody took while they were on the showroom floor. But the second Shout that we've seen revealed is Drain Vitality. This is a 1-cost agility card, and it gives a creature -1/-1. Now the level 2, however, gives a creature -2/-2, which makes it better than Malefic Wreath at that value. And the level 3 version gives all enemy creatures -2/-2. That's right, all enemy creatures -2/-2. So that's not in a lane. It's just all enemy creatures, and it's 1 Magicka. So this one is also kind of bonkers. Even at level 1, it's not terrible. It's an overcosted curse, and curse already sees play, but part of the reason curse sees as much play as it does is because of Goblin Skulk being able to fetch it, and cards like Murkwater Shaman that create it. But there still might be room for Drain Vitality to make an appearance in those decks. I don't know. This one really interests me. The -- is not irrelevant because it certainly hits things with ward, and that's important. It's not as important as it used to be in the past, but with this new set rolling around, who knows? But it certainly appeals to me. So this card is interesting. Now, this one is in agility, and the previous one was in strength. These are the only two that have been revealed so far, but I think it's probably safe to assume that there's likely going to be one in each attribute. It has been confirmed that they are all going to be commons, so that will be interesting. We'll kind of see how that affects Arena and whether or not the other cards that supposedly synergize with this impact them that much. So we do know, supposedly, again, that there are going to be cards that will also level up your shouts. And there are some cards that let you either find your shouts or give you shouts at random. So on that note, let's talk about one of the ones that finds a shout. And this is a good transition because, again, sorry for the potato quality image, but this image actually shows two new cards. The first is Greybeard Mentor. This is a 4-cost 2/2 neutral Nord. And on summon, it will find a random shout from your deck. Now, random sounds bad, but because it's from your deck, you can kind of control what you're tutoring for. And that's really important, right? So if you are running a Drain Vitality deck and that is your focus, then Mentor is fantastic. He will find you the copies, let you level up that specific shout. Great. The random is negated. I really like that they made this card neutral because if they do have shouts, again, that are part of each attribute, then this guy in a shout-focused deck would be potentially a natural include. I'll be curious to see if decks revolve around shouts in a way where you play multiple shouts or in a way where you focus on just leveling one and abusing it. I think that's going to be really, really interesting to me because I could see scenarios, again, we don't know enough yet, but I could see scenarios where you maybe, say, play a mage deck, and even though we haven't seen either the willpower or the intelligence shouts, you might pick one, focus on leveling it, and then bouncing it with Aaron, and doing all these neat tricks with it, but just keeping the one because you're focused on leveling it. And I could potentially just see you going, like, raw late-game power, where you just want broken shouts all the time, so you play both of them. Again, we haven't seen anything, we don't know enough yet, but it's interesting to think about. Now, the other card that's on this image, and I want to talk about it, is Shearpoint Dragon. Shearpoint Dragon is a 6-cost 4/4 dragon, derp. The summon, however, is give a creature -2/-2. So you get a 4/4 body that gives -2/-2, so you're paying 6 for 6's worth of stats, which is not bad for a rare. Also, when you reduce another creature's power or health with another effect, you increase it by 1. So, if you play this with Drain Vitality, the level 1 gives -2/-2, the level 2 gives -3/-3, and so on and so forth. This would also work with Curses, this would also work with Murkwater Witch, Chorus Reapers, whoever comes in the set that also provides -2/-2s, right? This guy would also buff them, or just playing other Shearpoint Dragons. As a potential like agility control card, this really intrigues me. It kind of intrigues me a lot. So I'm curious to see if this card ends up being viable. I'm curious to see if Drain Vitality works in its favor. Both of those kind of caught my eye from the cards that were revealed this week. So they are exciting. At least I think they're exciting. Interesting synergies. Now, there is another green dragon that was revealed this week. This one is Dova of the Voice. This one was revealed specifically in a PC Gamer article, and the image is much clearer, so hooray for that. This is a 7-cost 6/4 dragon, and it says Last Gasp, put a random shout into your hand. This is also a common. Now, again, there is no way to tell if these things are good or bad yet. But if we were basing it strictly on the current meta, this feels really lackluster. Now, it might be okay in something like Arena, and it is a common, but you're paying 7 for something with a 4 health in a format where Lightning Bolt is like the standard, and the Last Gasp is a random shout, so even if you're playing a shout-focused deck, there's no guarantee you're going to get a shout that synergizes with what you were playing. I think this one has too much working against it. Again, I could be wrong, right? But just with what we know right now, this one looks a little rough. But the art, I think, is pretty cool. And it's great to see Agility getting a couple of dragons now. And it's great to see them, again, kind of reinforcing this shout theme throughout the expansion and this dragon theme throughout the expansion. So, you know, whatever. I'm excited. All right, so the last one. Mentor of the Watch. Again, grainy picture, I'm sorry. Mentor of the Watch is a 2/2 guard with prophecy. summon, give a creature in your hand guard. So this one is interesting because it reminds me a lot of that like buff your hand mechanic from Hearthstone. Now this isn't a buff, it gives something guard, but it's still in that same vein. I'm curious to see if they kind of lean heavier on the like guards that buff other things with guards, like the captain in the base set, because otherwise I don't see a lot of value in this. Like, getting new prophecy cards is fine. It'll probably matter a bit more in Arena, but for constructed play at 3 costs, the stats feel lackluster. Again, who knows? The set could reveal something that makes this awesome, but like, as of right now, today, if you were to compare this versus like Dark Guardian, I don't think that the prophecy makes up for the -3 health, and I don't think that giving something in your hand guard matters a ton. It might matter. So the only way I could see that mattering is if you were ever trying to play a control deck that didn't have willpower. So with the base set, willpower is kind of the standard for control decks because Hive Defender is just that important of a card because of the raw stats and the guard. So something like this in theory could set up another creature with similar stats that didn't have guard to maybe fill that role. But now you're like draw dependent, and I don't know, it's a little quirky. Also in this image, it might be kind of hard to see, there's a Karthspire something dragon and willpower. We don't really get to see the stats, but we see part of the title in the hand, and we do see it on the board. We also see a 7/7 dragon with regenerate, but we don't know anything else about it. And we also see Alduin, who has an 18 cost, and it looks like it's already been discounted once or twice, or who knows. So we're going to get a guy that is crazy expensive to play, and he's probably going to do something really, really awesome and cool. So, yeah, we don't know what he does yet. We can only see him in the hand in this image, but I look forward to whenever that thing gets spoiled, because I'm sure it's going to be ridiculous. So that's it for the cards that have been for sure revealed. The PC Gamer article in text tried to explain some other cards. The only reason I'm not talking about them here is because we don't have images to confirm, and when the article was first published, they were also including like Wrath of Sithis as if it was a spoiled card, which we know is not a new card at all. So I just question like validity and memory. Chances are the stuff that they're talking about in that article will just prove to be correct, but as of right now, because of no images and because of how wonky that article was at publishing. And so that's it for the cards that have been released since the last video that I did on newly released cards. Some of these are pretty exciting. I, in particular, am excited about trying out Drain Vitality and Shearpoint Dragon. It's probably too early to determine if these are going to be good or not, but they at least kind of caught my eye in terms of trying some sort of agility-based control deck that focuses on the like minus-minus style of play. I think that there's a lot of room to explore there, so I'm kind of excited to try it out. That being said, I did want to take the time real briefly to say that tomorrow, so June 17th, I'm going to be doing another giveaway stream. So it'll be just like the last one. I'm going to be starting a little bit later than last time, though. So 10 p.m. Eastern time. So again, that's June 17th, 10 p.m. Eastern time. I'll be live, and just like last week's giveaway stream, I will be giving away codes for packs, and I'll be giving away one copy of the Fall of the Dark Brotherhood expansion. So you just got to show up periodically throughout the stream. I'll start a raffle. You enter the raffle. If you win, you get a code for either two packs or the expansion when we do that part as well. So hopefully I'll see you guys there. As always, I appreciate you watching the videos and coming to hang out. It means a ton. I've been noticing the subs have certainly been picking up as of late. We're getting closer and closer to 1,000. And I think when I hit 1,000, I might, to celebrate, do some sort of like Q&A video. The people who come by stream pretty much get to interact with me live and ask a lot of questions. So I think they have like a better working knowledge of me as opposed to the people who only consume my content through YouTube. So it might be a good time for people to ask questions that I may have answered in the past, but you might have missed it just because, you know, as I said, I was doing it on stream and not in the YouTube videos. So Yeah, we might do like a Q&A thing for hitting 1,000 subs, which is hopefully in the near future. If we stay at the pace we're going, it actually might even be by the end of the month. So there's that to look forward to. But yeah, I love you guys. Hope to see you next time. Until then, may you walk on warm sands.